So I say to him, then I guess you wouldn't mind if I fucked her.
No.
And he says to me without missing a beat, I thought you already had. Now at this point, I don't know what he's thinking. He could be trying to add levity to a very awkward situation. Or maybe someone told him that she was playing hide the salami with me every other Tuesday at my cousin Richie's apartment. So I say to him, Sammy, what would make you think a thing like that?
No, he didn't.
Yeah.
And he says, it was the way you were looking at it the other day. He was right. She was looking at me like I was a popsicle on a hot summer's day. And my magnetic eyes were riveted to her buns of steel, which were barely concealed by a teeny-weeny leopard print mini dress.
Mini dress?
A leopard print mini dress, yeah.
So what do you say?
I looked him in the eye, finished my beer, and I said, you're right, Sammy. You caught me. I was looking at her. I was looking at your wife, and I was thinking, what is a beautiful woman like you doing with a little big bastard like that? And he hit me over the head with a Corona bottle.
You are one crazy son of a bitch.
No, I'm not.
I don't understand. I thought you liked Sammy. Why'd you start screwing his wife?
Yeah, I didn't.
You just told me you were doing it at your cousin Richie's apartment.
No, I did not.
Dude, she just said it.
I did not. That is your problem, Jack. You don't listen. What I said was, maybe somebody told him we were doing it. I never said we actually did it. There's a big difference.
Then why'd you embarrass him like that?
Like what?
You call him a little dick bastard.
Oh, he does have a little dick.
What?
Jack. We both know he's unlike a little puce.
I have no idea how big or small Sam's pecker is.
Are you gonna sit there and act like you've never seen Sammy's Johnson?
What the fuck are you talking about? When would I have seen his dick?
The Boy Scouts? Camp Minnetonka? The showers every day for 2 weeks.
The Boy Scouts?
Dicks everywhere.
We were kids, Deuce.
Did you see his package or not?
We were kids.
Did you?
Even if I had seen Sammy's Jimmy, I wouldn't remember its mentions. It's something you see, but you don't look at.
Jack, that is the biggest load of shit I ever heard come out of you.
Can we change the topic?
A King Kong loaf.
Believe it or not, I'd spend my spare time looking at male genitalia.
Is that right?
What are we doing? We're supposed to be celebrating. We're supposed to be smoking cigars, drinking 25-year-old scotch. We're supposed to be talking about titty bars and planning my bachelor party, not talking about Sammy's little Woody.
Hmm. Aha!
Aha.
Aha.
Aha what?
You just said Sammy's little Woody.
Yeah, so?
So, you wouldn't have said little Woody if you didn't remember what it looks like.
Bullshit. I said little because you kept saying it was little.
Right.
You said it was little.
So, you're saying you don't remember what Sammy's dick looks like?
Do you know what my dick looks like? We go to the gym together 3 times a week, and you don't know what my dick looks like. You're telling me you don't know what my dick looks like?
I don't care what it looks like.
I've seen you looking at my dick. It's only
you've never seen me looking at your dick.
Deny it if you want to, but I have caught your wandering eyes on several occasions. It's no big deal. I've looked at yours.
I'm not gonna talk about this anymore. It was amusing at first, but now you're getting sick.
Are you so insecure that you can't handle a perfectly innocent discussion of the male sexual organ?
You know, you're starting to sound
like what?
Like a fucking queer.
You got something against queers?
No, I don't have anything against queers.
10%, you know.
Bullshit. 10%, 1%.
At least 10%. Believe what you want to believe, but truth will set you free.
1%.
Rock Hudson.
So?
Montgomery Cliff.
Says you.
Danny Kaye.
Surprise, surprise.
Danny Kaye was Laurence Olivier's law.
Right.
Langston Hughes.
No, you mean Bull.
No, I mean Langston.
Bull.
Justin Timberlake.
Obviously.
Queen Latifah.
Rumors.
Whitney.
I used to think that too, but she's married now.
Everyone knows Bobby is a flaming queen.
They are married. Married with children.
Calvin Klein got married too, so what? J. Edgar Hoover.
Old news.
LL Cool J.
LL Cool J.
LL Cool J.
You're being ridiculous.
Wilt Chamberlain.
You don't believe that.
Wilt was riding Bill Russell's pole for years.
This is just silly.
Angela Davis.
Angela Davis, come on, don't fuck with Angela Davis.
This is not speculation, Jack. She's out, swear to God. She's out, stone cold lesbian.
Where'd you hear this?
It's common knowledge.
People have often asked me over the years, how did you become an activist? And what made you decide to become an activist? What was that pivotal event in your life?
Okay, how about this one? Associate Supreme Court Justice David Souter.
That, I believe.
Jimi Hendrix.
Jimi Hendrix was a notorious ladies' man. Little Richard, Luther, Cisco, yes. Jimi, no.
Hendrix was gay.
Jimi Hendrix was straight.
Straight up your ass.
That's fucking ridiculous.
It's like I said, Jack, the problem is you don't listen. If you listen to one of his songs, it all becomes crystal clear.
What song?
Purple Haze.
I know Purple Haze. There are no shocking sexual revelations in there.
If you listen to that song, there is a line that gives it all away. Think about it.
What line?
Excuse me while I kiss this guy.
You're a fucking moron. The line is, excuse me while I kiss the sky. Not excuse me while I kiss this guy.
Right, what? You think I was born yesterday? Kiss the sky, my ass.
You're an idiot.
Smarten up, Jack. Homosexuals play a significant role in our society.
You can't shock me, Deuce.
Is that right?
That's right.
Huey P. Newton.
Bullshit. That is complete bullshit, and you know it.
I am just telling you what I heard from a family friend.
Some white guy who doesn't know fucking anything.
A former member of the Black Panther Party from Oakland. A brother with no reason to lie.
He said, apparently,
Huey kicked Bobby.
I don't want to hear it.
Not only did he beat the shit out of him, he then proceeded to rip his clothes off and rape him. It's the truth.
It's a lie. Admit it.
No.
Admit it.
No.
Admit it.
Jack, I'm gay.
Yeah, I know that, Deuce. I'm a lesbian trapped in a man's body. Never give up, do you?
I'm serious. I am a homosexual. There. I said it.
Congratulations. Cut that shit out. I'm not kidding. Stop it.
What'd I do?
Stop touching my ass.
I didn't touch your ass.
What did you just do?
I was grabbing your ass. Do you understand the difference?
Would you stop this stupid game of yours? What the fuck? Oh, you must be out of your motherfucking mind thinking I'm gonna let you get away kissing me in public.
Is that why you're mad? I guess I should have waited till we had some privacy.
Deuce, you've had your laugh. Ha ha. Okay, but now it's gotta stop. A joke is a joke, but the rumor of homosexuality spreads faster than butt cheeks in a bathhouse. So stop it.
I'm not joking. I'm coming out to you. I'm telling you, my best friend. I'm telling you.
I've been a victim of your sick sense of humor too many times to fall for this. I know you better than you know you. And you're as hetero as they come.
Didn't it ever seem strange to you that I never had a girlfriend in college?
No. You were fucking everything that moved. Why would you want a girlfriend?
Please, Jack. I'm trying to tell you the truth.
Okay, you're a faggot. I believe you. Okay, faggot?
Okay, nigger.
What the fuck was that?
What?
Nigger, what kind of shit is that? You can't say some shit like that to me and expect to get away with it.
just called me a faggot.
So what?
It's the same thing.
It is not.
It is.
Calling me a nigger is not a joke. We're friends, but you are not black. You cannot call me nigger, no matter how close we are. Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm not kidding. I'm not kidding at all. Do you understand?
I understand, but you understand this. Every time you call me a faggot, I will call you a nigger.
This isn't funny anymore, okay? That faggot stuff is just some bullshit you started. You fucking instigated the whole goddamn thing.
Jack, I am gay. I have sex with men. I have been gay all my life, and I will not tolerate you calling me faggot, no matter how trendy the term may have become within certain segments of our community. Jack.
Deuce.
Jack, you're my best friend. I'm telling you this because we need to be honest with one another. I called you nigger to get your attention and to change the tone of the conversation. I'm sorry I said it, okay, but I didn't know what else to do.
You can't be serious.
What do you want me to do? Kiss you on the mouth this time?
Wait a minute, you've had lots of women.
Yeah, and I have fried many eggs, but that does not make me a chef.
You're bi.
No, I'm gay. But sure, I've been with women.
You're bullshitting me.
No, I am not.
How many Judy Garland CDs do you have?
What?
Judy Garland. How many CDs?
What the fuck are you talking about?
All gay men love Judy Garland.
How many watermelons do you have in your refrigerator?
Fuck you!
Fuck you!
Look, let us say, for the sake of argument, that this is true. And you really are a fudge packer.
Jungle bunny.
That you really are a homosexual. If this is true, God, if this is true, I don't even know you. If this is true, you're not really my friend because you've been lying to me for 17 years.
Oh, excuse me, you've never lied to me?
Not about something like this.
There is nothing like this.
Yes, there is.
What?
What
is like this?
Okay, here's something. Remember when we were in the 8th grade, cut school, and spent the day getting stoned in my parents' garage?
There were many days like that.
Well, on this particular day, we found a box full of my father's old Playboys.
Yes, and?
And you asked me if I had ever whacked off.
Wait a minute, I don't remember this.
And even though this is the most traumatic and embarrassing memory of my youth, I told you about my father catching me flogging my dolphin.
Spanking your monkey?
Choking my chicken over his favorite Ohio Players album cover.
Jack, telling a masturbation story is not at all on par with admitting that one is a homosexual.
Yes, it is. It was really embarrassing.
Really embarrassing?
Yeah.
My sexual orientation is not embarrassing to me. It's not about being embarrassed. It's about being rejected by your family and friends. It's about my life being in danger if I show affection for another man in front of the wrong people. It's about being a second-class citizen.
My heart bleeds for you, Deuce.
Fuck
you! I feel so bad for you.
Fuck you! Fuck you and fuck that fucking closet that you stuck in.
Pardon me?
You're the faggot, Jack. You. I open up to you and what do? You fucking mock me?
I did not mock you.
So, Jack, when are you gonna come out?
What do you mean?
Say that, okay?
What do you mean?
You're gay too. I know it, you know it, so let's just save the BS for another topic, okay?
You motherfuckers are all the same. Why do you people think everyone is gay? It's fucking ridiculous.
You people?
This is why a straight man can't be friends with a homo. Sooner or later, that homo is gonna think you're a homo too.
You're pathetic.
I'm pathetic? At least I know the truth about who I am. I'm honest. At least I'm honest.
Is that right?
Honest to a fault.
Good. I didn't want to have to do this, but you have forced my hand.
Is that right?
Are you going to sit there and swear to me that you have never engaged in homosexual activity?
I'm not even sure homosexuality even exists.
not even sure.
I've heard about it, but I've never seen anyone actually engage in such acts. Consequently, it's possible that this lifestyle does not exist.
Well, answer this. Have you ever modeled in the nude?
Sure, why?
I'm sorry, let me rephrase that question. Has your penis ever modeled in the nude?
What the fuck are you talking about?
Do you know who Robert Mapplethorpe is?
Who?
He's a very famous photographer. More than that, he's a very important artist.
Okay, and?
And, despite the fact that you claim not to be a gay man, I have very strong, uncircumcised evidence that you are lying.
Is that right?
One of Mapplethorpe's most famous images is entitled Man in Polyester Suit. And Jack, it's a photograph of you.
A photo of me, taken by a famous photographer, and no one has ever mentioned it to me?
Well, your face does not appear on the photo.
Then how do you know it's me?
It is a photo of your penis. It is a photograph of you, dressed in a suit, with your phallus hanging out to fly.
If it's just a phallus, what makes you think it's me?
Jack, I know what your penis looks like.
Don't start that shit again.
I can prove it.
How?
I have a copy of the photo right here.
Show me.
I could do that. Or you could make this simple and admit the truth for once in your life. Believe me, it's a very emancipating feeling.
Dude, you don't know anything about the truth.
I know the truth about you.
You think you know the truth about me?
Mapplethorpe took a photo of your penis, and yet you deny being gay. Come on. One does not get one's penis photographed often in life. It's not like you could have forgotten about it. Mapplethorpe photographed your foreskin wiener. Now, maybe you didn't know who he was, but there is no way in the world a straight man is going to meet a size queen like Mapplethorpe and let him photograph his penis. Oh, and before I forget, look what I found.
Okay. I am gay. I'm gay. I'm gay. You happy now?
Very.
You never would have known if it wasn't for the Mapplethorpe photo.
I've known for years.
Bullshit.
I knew.
Then why are you bringing it up just now?
You were never engaged to be married before now.
So what?
You can't go through with it.
Why not?
Jack. You can't.
She's a lesbian.
Bullshit.
Seriously.
Motherfucker!
What?
You told her before you admitted it to me?
Show me the photo.
What photo?
The photograph of my... The photo. Deuce, this is not my penis.
I know. Can we get another round, please?